You begin your journey not knowing where it will take you. You have plans, you have dreams. But every now and again you have to take uncharted roads, face impassable mountains, cross treacherous rivers, be blocked by landslides and earthquakes. That's the way my life has been. I never planned to go into politics, but my years in London and the Japanese occupation changed my view of the world. Once in a long while in the history of people, there comes a moment of great change. To disavow your old beliefs in the light of your personal experience. Countries, like individuals, have to grow up and face the facts of life. They have to learn how to live with their neighbors and fend for themselves in a harsh and predatory world. If you have no idealism when you are young, then you must become an intolerable cynic long before you are old. I stand, fight, live and die by what I say. Let us be friends with all our neighbors. But in order that friendship can be meaningful and worth anything, let it be clearly understood that in our own home, we order our own furniture and we arrange it the way we like. A foolhardy man does not necessarily deserve a medal for valor. It is when a man knows what the odds are and says, "Notwithstanding that, I must do so." That is valor. Every time we look back on this moment when we signed this agreement, it will be a moment of anguish. For me, it is a moment of anguish because all my life, the whole of my adult life, I had believed in merger and the unity of these two territories. It broke everything we stood for. If you want people to stand up and take note of what you say, then it is in moments of acute pain or crisis or anguish that you should stand up to be counted. Can anybody really see himself for what he is? It is a very subjective thing. I would like to see myself as somebody who's doing something which he thinks is right and which I hope, in the end, will succeed. I do not want to sound like a hawk or dove. If I have to choose a metaphor from aviary, I would like to think of the owl. And from now onwards, we start from this basis, gentlemen. The world does not owe us a living. And the corollary is also true, that we do not owe the world a living. Of Angkor are silent witnesses to the glories of a great civilization. They can only have been created by a great people, but they underline a cruel truth that no one can take for granted their peace, security, and continued prosperity. It is not predetermination, but determination that decides what happens to a people. I'm not interested in being politically correct. I'm interested in being correct. A 100 years ago, this was a mud flat swamp. Today, this is a modern city. You begin your journey not knowing where it will take you. You have plans, you have dreams. But every now and again you have to take uncharted roads, face impassable mountains, cross treacherous rivers, be blocked by landslides and earthquakes. That's the way my life has been. At the end of the day, what have I got? A successful Singapore. What have I given up? My life.